doubt you, Lord, but the night is as clear as the day.
O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Psalm 124 to 126.
If the Lord had not been on our side, let Israel now say.
If the Lord had not been on our side, when enemies rose up against us,
then would they have swallowed us up alive. In their fierce anger towards us,
then would the waters have overwhelmed us, and the torrent gone over us.
Then would the raging waters have gone right over us.
Blessed be the Lord. He has not given us over to be a prey for their teeth.
We have escaped like a bird from the snare of a fowler. The snare is broken and we have escaped.
Our help is in the name of the Lord, the Maker of heaven and earth.
Those who trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion, which cannot be moved but stands fast forever.
The hills stand above Jerusalem, so does the Lord stand round about his people from this time forth forevermore.
The scepter of the wicked shall not hold sway over the land allotted to the just, so that the just shall not put their hands to evil.
Show your goodness, O Lord, to those who are good, and to those who are true of heart.
As for those who turn aside to crooked ways, the Lord will deliver them away with evil doers. But peace be upon Israel. When the Lord restored the fortunes of Zion, then were we like those who dream.
Then was our mouth filled with laughter, and our tongue with shouts of joy.
Then said they among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them.
The Lord has done great things for us, and we are glad indeed.
Restore our fortunes, O Lord, like the water courses of the Negev.
Those who sowed with tears will reap with songs of joy.
Those who God weeping carrying the seed will come again with joy, shouldering their sheaves.
Glory to the Father and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Book of the prophet Zechariah, the 11th chapter, beginning the 4th verse. Thus says the Lord my God, be a shepherd of the flock doomed to slaughter. Those who buy them kill them and go unpunished. And those who sell them say, Blessed be the Lord, for I have become rich. And their own shepherds have no pity on them. For I will no longer have pity on the inhabitants of the earth, says the Lord. I will cause them every one to fall each into the hand of a neighbour, and each into the hand of the king, and they shall devastate the earth, and I will deliver no one from their hand. So, on behalf of the sheep merchants, I became the shepherd of the flock doomed to slaughter. I took two staffs, one I named Favour, the other I named Unity, and I tended the sheep. In 1 month I disposed of 3 shepherds, for I had become impatient with them, and they had also deserted me. So I said, I will not be your shepherd. What is to die, let it die. What is to be destroyed, let it be destroyed. And let those that are left devour the flesh of one another. I took my staff Favour and broke it, annulling the covenant that I had made with all the peoples. So it was annulled on that day, and the sheep merchants who were watching me knew that it was the word of the Lord. I then said to them, If it seems right to you, give me my wages, but if not, keep them. So they weighed out my wages, 30 shekels of silver. Then the Lord said to me, Throw it into the treasury, this lordly price at which I was valued by them. So I took the 30 shekels of silver and threw them into the treasury in the house of the Lord. Then I broke my second staff, Unity, annulling the family ties between Judah and Israel. Then the Lord said to me, Take once more the implements of a worthless shepherd, for I am now raising up in the land a shepherd who does not care for the perishing, or seek the wandering, or heal the maimed, or nourish the healthy, but devours the flesh of the fat ones, faring off, tearing off even the hoofs. O my worthless shepherd who deserts my flock, may the sword strike his arm and his right eye. Let his be completely withered, his right eye utterly blinded. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Exultet spiritus meus in Domino Deo, salutari meo.
My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord, my spirit rejoices in God my Saviour.
For he has looked with favour on his lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones, and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Exultet spiritus meus in Domino Deo. Salutari meo.
Gospel of Matthew, the 19th chapter, beginning at the 13th verse. The little children were being brought to Jesus in order that he might lay his hands on them and pray. The disciples spoke sternly to those who brought them, but Jesus said, Let the little children come to me and do not stop them, for it is to such as these that the kingdom of heaven belongs. And he laid his hands on them and went on his way. Then someone came to him and said, Teacher, what good deed must I do to have eternal life? He said to him, Why do you ask me what is good? There is only one who is good. If you wish to enter into life, keep the commandments. He said to him, Which ones? And Jesus said, You shall not murder, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not steal, you shall not bear false witness, honor your father and mother, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. The young man said to him, I have kept all these, what do I still lack? Jesus said to him, If you wish to be perfect, go sell your possessions and give the money to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Then come and follow me. When the young man heard this word, he went away grieving, for he had many possessions. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, you now have set your servant free to go in peace as you have promised. For these eyes of mine have seen the Saviour, whom you have prepared for all the world to see, a light to enlighten the nations and the glory of your people Israel. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of sins, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
That this evening may be holy, good, and peaceful,
we entreat you, O Lord,
that your holy angels may lead us in paths of peace and goodwill.
We entreat you, O Lord,
that we may be pardoned and forgiven for our sins and offences.
We entreat you, O Lord,
that there may be peace to your church and to the whole world.
We entreat you, O Lord,
that we may depart this life in your faith and fear, and not be condemned before the great judgment seat of Christ.
We entreat you, O Lord,
that we may be bound together by your Holy Spirit in the communion of the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. John the Evangelist, and all your saints, entrusting one another and all our life to Christ.
We entreat you, O Lord.
Almighty and everlasting God, whose will it is to restore all things in your well-beloved Son, the King of kings and Lord of lords, mercy grant that the peoples of the earth, divided and enslaved by sin, may be freed and brought together under his most gracious rule, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God now and forever.
Amen.
Most holy God, the source of all good desires, all right judgments, and all just works, give to us, your servants, that peace which the world cannot give, so that our minds may be fixed on the doing of your will, and that we, being delivered from the fear of our enemies, may live in peace and quietness, through the mercies of Christ Jesus, our Saviour.
Amen.
Be our light in the darkness, O Lord, and in your great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this life, for the love of your only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
O God, the life of all who live, the life of the faithful, the strength of those who labour and the repose of the dead, we thank you for the blessings of the day that has passed, and humbly ask your protection through this coming night. Bring us in safety to the morning light, through him who died and rose again for us, even your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Let us bless them.
Thanks be to God.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all ever.
Amen.